going for it. We built a desk.
The title of our project was The Executive Desk for the Young Child.
By Team 3.
Of course.
Section 14.
Team 3.
Alright, so here's the overview for our project. When we were brainstorming ideas, we knew we wanted to design a product that was beneficial to the world. So we decided to go with an adjustable classroom desk. Because we did research and studies show that students do a lot better when they're standing up during class and paying attention rather than just sitting all day. It's known as, like, there's this new study that says sitting is the new cancer. So we wanted to do something to help that. We based our design off this desk right here, found it on Google, a nice little childish desk. And we made it something very sophisticated and beautiful. Okay, so this is our final design, and as I said before, we came up with a very sophisticated design. And right here you can see the cost for all the main materials that we use. So teak wood, which is kind of expensive but very high quality, was used for the top desk and the bottom desk, the desktops. We used titanium for the hinges, so they'd be nice and sturdy. And then we use aluminum for the legs because they're sturdy enough and they get the job done. We also use steel for all the screws that are going in because there's a lot of them. And then we use iron for the magnetic backing boards to create a magnetic surface for the children to use during class.
So the team evenly divided the components between all of us to make building it as easy as we could on each individual, where we just compile all the parts in one major assembly. Katie chose to do the leg portions while Mackenzie focused on the board sections, while Anthony constructed the screws and the arms connecting the two boards, while I made the marker holders as well as the screw to connect the marker holder to the main desk. And I also made a hinge for the two tabletops as well as a male and a female adapter to connect multiple desks together all at once. And on top of that, we use the GroupMe app, which is a very useful app, by the way, to communicate with each other outside of class, and we try to meet up at least once every 2 weeks to just sort of see how we were all doing and get sort of progress reports and help each other out when necessary.
So overall, we liked our design. In the evaluation process, we realized that we kind of changed from a creative design for a child to more sophisticated design that looked very nice and sleek, and maybe a child would be the best focus group for it. We also made some changes. We had some basic shapes, such as cylinders, that we changed to squares, and we decided to make, we originally had a cup holder and a pivot joint that we got rid of due to time constraints. If we improved on this in the future, we would probably have a height change apparatus that was easier for a child to use and a more advanced hinge system.
Go.
So part of our original assembly, we tried to make it as simple as possible, so for a child, of course. So of course our design is very barbaric, I guess you could call it. But we tried to make things, you try to spice things up and make things more interesting. So what we ended up adding was a whiteboard, a cup holder, and you could use it for markers too if you wanted to. We were going to add a pivot joint, but because of time constraints, we couldn't. Extendable legs, Katie was successful in doing that. Male-female attachments, that was David, he did one of those out with those. That was so you could connect multiple desks, so it's not just one per table, you could combine multiple and get a group thing going on. You have parts to allow change between the whiteboard and the desk, so that would be the arms that I designed so that they can pivot, so it can close and open easily. And a marker holder, that's also the cup holder that David designed.
So my final design kind of changed my original assembly. I have an inner leg part. I also have an outer leg part, which isn't shown here. I had an attachment between the inner leg part and the table, and feet of the table, which I changed from circular pattern to a rectangular pattern. So the part I changed most was probably the table feet. I changed the depth from like 6.5 to 7. I added a slot and used a rectangular pattern along the bottom. And I fixed dimensions from the original, which I had problems with when submitted. also gave holes a clearance and tolerance, and I completed the inner leg and outer leg assembly shown in figure four.
Okay, so for my parts of the project, throughout the assembly, they pretty much stayed the same throughout the whole process, except for a couple changes that were necessary in order to accompany my teammates' parts. So I was going to have a tabletop with an indented pocket. That stayed the same. We had the magnetic board that was constrained between the whiteboard and the wood, as shown right here. We had a whiteboard, and then we had a base desk. So for the modified portion of my project, I modified the final design for the base desk. So it started with adding holes to the bottom. You can't really see it in this picture, but there's four sets of four holes in order to screw in Katie's leg assembly. And then we had to add a visual thread in order to screw in David's screw in order to connect the marker holder to the base desk. And then we had to change the depths and the dimensions in order to fit Anthony's parts. And we also engraved our company's name and the side of the desk for a little creativity. But overall, the base desk has become kind of like the center portion of everyone's parts. And so everyone has to connect their parts to this desk, and so it had to become pretty important. We also added a pocket to make it easier for desks to be connected in order to decrease the gap between desks if you connect them.
Along with the other changes, I also added tolerances to pretty much every hole on the base desk in order to fit the parts that were being attached to it perfectly. So for example, the 16 holes on the bottom of the base desk were tolerance to have an interference fit, because when the leg subassembly is being attached, we want that friction, so it's going to be a very tight fit in order to decrease the chances of anything falling out, because we want this desk to be very sturdy.
Okay, so the original plan that I had for making my parts was making, first off, a holder for the markers that would go on the front of the desk, which is pictured here, a screw for the marker holder right here, which would go through this hole or this hole into a hole that's already in the desk and threaded to match the screw. I also made a hinge for the two tabletops, which for that I actually made two separate parts. A leaf here and a leaf here, where I just made one, mirrored it and flipped it, and then made a pin to just go straight through the middle where it would be able to rotate, open and close. And then for figures 4 and 5, I made the female and male table attachments. However, the male table attachment, the design was actually changed. This was the initial design, but that ended up not working out, which I will go more in depth in the next slide about what changed with that part. Okay, so this is the page for my modified assembly. Like I said before about the last page, the main thing that changed throughout the design of all my parts was the male table attachment. The main difference between what was shown on the previous slide and this one here is the fact that it basically has one external peg rather than two, and instead of this whole part being part of the external piece, this part actually goes into a pocket within the desk itself in order to save space, because the older design that I had just would have taken up far too much space. And that leads me into the female desk attachment, where it stayed the same. The only difference is, rather than this being flipped externally, instead, this also went into a pocket on the side of the desk, so that way the desks would just be able to be side by side without having that gap for the attachments like the original design had. So overall, this design just saves much more space and is much more efficient.
For the male and female attachments for the table, I gave the female attachment a slightly larger hole than the diameter of the peg coming out for the male attachment. This was to create a clearance fit so they could fit just well enough into each other where they could secure the desks without being too loose as to possibly break off the male peg, but also enough to keep them secured so that they wouldn't come undone unless you wanted them to come undone.
So I was tasked with the arms and the screws And so mainly for the idea of the arms, nothing really changed. I just figured they'd be little round ovals, like you call them, with holes at the end of them that you could connect to something in the middle. That's what changed the most for me, was the part that connected the two arms. I needed something that could pivot so that the table could close and open freely. But the design I currently made at first didn't really work out because it was too, you know, prone to fail. That was probably one of the hardest things I faced, but in the end, it all worked out because I found a piece that, you know how ladders open and close, there's a metal piece that keeps it from reopening. I kind of copied that design with, of course, my own ingenuity, with little pins on each end so they could attach into the table. That was the hardest part, was attaching it into the table, because I had to find the constraints, I had to find where we should put the holes inside the table. That was by far the most annoying thing about this entire project, but I learned a lot from it. Here's a formal drawing of what it looks like when it's flat and opened, and here's a screw that I designed so that we could attach the legs that Katie designed over into the table itself.